The man we're going to be talking to about editing, why it is important and why it is used and how it grew to be what it is today.
What is editing? Edit is basically the coming together of all the footage that has been collected over days or weeks of filming. In this process, you can add visual effects or CGI to any part of the media production. It also allows tightening up of small features and adding or taking out minor glitches. The reason editing is so important is simply because if the editing didn't happen, the media productions that you've seen wouldn't have been anywhere near the standard of quality that they are. Films such as Transformers, The Hobbit and Harry Potter are all made as good as they are thanks to the use of editing, which is the reason why you can see the movements and everything that happens.
Why do we edit? We edit because it is an extremely important part of the entire production of the media piece. This is because it's in the post-production stage, meaning it is at the end of the production process. This means after any mistakes that are made are then permanent and cannot be altered or changed. This means all imperfections and all CGI needs to be sorted and done properly to the best that it can possibly be done. When making a sequence that requires CGI, they do the filming in the green room. This is because it allows them to add effects over the top with a lot more ease. This is mostly because it is easier to suck the green pigment away from human skin as opposed to red or blue. This is because a change in red or blue in the shot can change the colour of the skin of the actor or actress. This will then mean a lot harder work for the editors. An example of a film that used a lot of CGI well is Marvel Avengers Assemble. As you will see, there is a lot of action going on in this particular scene, and all of the characters that you see the Marvel superheroes fighting are not actually there, but were put into the film using CGI in the editing stage. However, a bad example of the use of CGI in the film is Megalodon vs. Giant Octopus. As you can see, the creatures that the film is based around are not at all realistic, and therefore makes this a bad example of editing.
I knew they couldn't stay away from each other.
Looks like they finally finished what they started 18 million years ago.
Another way they do CGI and effects in media productions is the use of white dot sensors. which are little white balls or stickers that connect the actor or actress's movements to the computer screen. This is mostly used on humans during fight scenes as it allows the editors to overlay the actor with a computer-generated image. So the actor does all of the movements, but what we see on the screen is actually a creature of some sort that someone is fighting. This same technology is used in some video games, mostly wrestling games and realistic, such as SmackDown vs. Raw, Mortal Kombat, Assassin's Creed and Tomb Raider. However, this is also used in films. For example, in the Transformers films, there is an actor doing all that the Transformers do, and then the actual final product of the Transformer is then overlaid onto the actor's body, therefore giving the final product of the Transformers as you will see here.
Is there a problem?
Whoa, little Mexican standoff we got here.
Weapons down.
And we'll let you escape with your dignity. Drop him! That's good. Ironhide, watch out!
Decepticon punk. Class dismissed.
However, some scenes in films are completely CGI and no physical acting is needed during these scenes. This allows the editing team a lot more freedom with what they can do in that particular scene, as they are not restricted to what the actor or actresses can or can't do. One great example of this in a scene is the latest Spider-Man movie. This whole scene of the film done entirely by CGI.
All these souls, lost and alone, I can save them, I can cure them. There's no need to stop me, Peter.
Editing is, however, not only used for CGI and effects, it is also used to add lip syncing. This form of editing is mostly commonly used in music videos, but however is also used in some films which contain scenes such as Mamma Mia, High School Musical and also the Hannah Montana movie. All of these had the songs recorded separately to the film. This meant that during the editing stage, they had to lip-sync the song to the movement of actors or actresses' mouths. I have an example of a music video, and a part of the music video I'd like to show.
Guess who? Guess who? You miss me? You miss me? Jessica Simpson, sing the chorus.
When you walk through the door, it was clear to me. You're the one they adore, who they came to see.
Who they came
you're
to see.
Rock star,
baby.
Everybody wants
you.
Yeah. Who can really blame
can
you?
Really
we're
you.
The ones who made you.
Back by popular demand. Now pop a little Zantac for antacid if you can. You're ready to tackle any task that is at hand. How does it feel? Is it fantastic? Is it grand? Well, look at all the massive masses in the stands. Shady man, no, don't massacre the fans. Damn, I think Kim Kardashian's a man. She stomped him just because he asked to put his hands on a massive Gluteus Maximus again. Squeeze it in, switch it in, pass it to a friend. Can he come back as nasty as he can? Yes, he can. Don't ask me this again. He does not mean to last me in a fin. But Lindsay, please come back to seeing men. Samantha's a 2, you're practically a 10. I know you want me, girl. In fact, I see a grin. Now come in, girl.
However, the recently released Les Mis is the first ever film where they sung live on set, which has then required no lip-syncing in order to make the words fit. Lip-syncing is a key part of editing, as if the lip-sync doesn't match up, it can ruin the whole production. This is key when creating a music video or even an animated feature film.
Let's get you out of here, Buzz.
Don't you get it? You see the hat? I am Mrs. Nesbitt. Snap out of it, Buzz!
They also do chroma key during editing. This is when you take one colour out of a shot, making that colour disappear from the shot completely. This then allows to make visual effects. For example, if you get someone to dress in a blue suit and hold a football, through chroma key you can remove blue from the shot, which then makes the football look as though it's floating in midair with no help at all. This helps to add effects to the footage without having to use CGI all of the time. However, it is a very time-consuming process and will take a lot of perseverance. Finally, from editing, they can pick the best parts from each take of the footage and then lay this in the correct order in order to create the final effect. This allows them to film the same scene but from various different angles to pick out the best shot. One good example of this is from the movie Rocky V with the end fight scene. As you will see in this scene, there are a lot of changes between shots and the actors fight, and also quite a few flashbacks.
I get the NFL!
Get up, you son of a bitch! Mickey loves you.
Come on,
boy.
Go, Tommy! I didn't hear no bell!
Tommy.
One more round.
Tommy, get back. Come on, get back. What?
Tommy,
you don't need this.
Tommy,
you lose, you're finished.
I got one more round.
Come on.
I'm not going to knock you out this time. I'm going to put you through the street. One more round.
Come on, Rocky. Rocky, come on, Rocky.
Come on, Tommy.
What in the hell are you doing? Get up! What in the hell?
Get out!
the ball! Fight back, you ball! Fight back!
Editing has developed massively over the past 100 years, with new ways of editing constantly being invented and used to their full potential. However, this all starts back in the 1800s with a man called Edward James Muybridge, who was the first person to properly put together a moving image. This image was a jockey on a horse. This is a similar technique to what some people use today as a flick book, which is a series of the same image that alters a fraction in every new shot. This was a good and effective way of editing, but however, it was very time consuming, and also the quality of footage wouldn't be to a good standard either, as you will see. Also, the development of splicing has also helped push forward the movement of editing. Splicing is when you take a piece of 28mm stock, film stock, and literally cut it, stick it into the parts together where you want, with some sticky tape. This means that they would then be able to do more efficient editing, and means they could cut more to more than one angle during a scene of production. However, if they messed up one scene by cutting it too early or too late, this could have a massive effect on the whole production. In the 1970s, Star Wars was a new movement in the mode of editing, using a lot of visual effects that had never been used or done before. For example, this was the first development in advanced CGI, meaning it was the first stepping stone to get into the editing stage that we're at today. 1980s to 1990s, they used non-linear editing. This allowed them to film different sections at different times. For example, they could film the ending first and the beginning last. This has meant that there are a lot more possibilities to what films, music videos and even TV adverts are able to do in the way of editing their footage. From 2000 onwards, more recently, there have been films such as Toy Story, which are completely animated and CGI, and also films such as Avatar, which are filmed mostly in 3D. However, it's not only the technology that has gotten better, but also the general skills and talents of the editors is constantly enhancing and being able to create and do more and more each time they edit footage that's been collected. Technology does help them develop their skills. One of the biggest assets that editors nowadays have is the ability to copy pieces of footage from digital cameras or SD cards and be able to create countless amounts of those, meaning they can edit each copy differently and then decide which looks better without having to keep on deleting the work you have already done to one. Overall, editing has developed massively. It may not always be the easiest software to use, but the perks of being able to edit the way we can now are unlistable. I hope you have enjoyed this. I hope you have learned something new. Thanks for watching and listening.